This program was recorded with a live audience. Please forgive the occasional sound fluctuations.
Most people think of themselves as wanting to keep their lives balanced by changing around their behaviors. This program is not about changing behavior so much. It's really much more about alignment. We all emanated from the same place, every one of us. Everything in this universe, in this physical universe, comes from a source that we have come to call God, or soul, or spirit, or consciousness, or whatever. And it doesn't really matter what you call it. It's not what we call things that makes them what they are, even though we often end up fighting wars over what we call things and make the labels that we place on people and events and circumstances and beliefs the significant part of them. It's really not. And if we had magnifying glasses that we could tune on and turn up as hard as we could and look at this source that we all came from, it would have an appearance. It would look like something. The something that it would look like, in my humble opinion, would be something that is always creating, something that is kind, something that is loving, something that is very difficult to understand because it is almost exactly the opposite of what we have come to believe we are. It's a place of oneness. And oneness is very difficult for us to understand because we live in a world of two-ness, of dichotomies, of splits, of opposites. In the Bhagavad Gita, the great teachings of the in the Hindu religion, they teach one of the most important things they teach is the idea that we need to blend or fuse the dichotomies while we're in this world of form that we came into. But it's very difficult to do that for almost everyone. In fact, I would suggest that while we are incarnated into a physical body, it's an impossibility to do it exclusively and totally, unless you're a total complete saint. So that when we are in this physical world of splits and dichotomies and paradoxes, and it's a gigantic paradox, this whole idea of balance, of being in balance, because in a world of oneness, there's no such thing as a problem with balance. There's nothing to balance. Everything is one. Try to imagine what it must be like to return to the world from which you came. To be in a place that has no beginnings and no ends. To even grasp the concept of infinite or infinity or eternal. It's almost more than we can bear. I remember being a young boy living in a foster home out in Mount Clemens, Michigan. The lady that we lived with, her name was Mrs. Scarf, she came down one day, and my brother Dave and I were there with a whole bunch of other children that lived there. And she handed each one of us a banana. It's a day that stands out in my mind very dramatically. And she handed us this banana at 231 Town Hall Road when I was about 6 years old, and Dave was seven. And she had tears streaming down her face, and she said, Mr. Scarf died this morning. I had never heard the word before. That was my first ever encounter with the word death. And as a six-year-old who had never heard that, I just looked up at her and I said,
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.